Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing how to identify the muscles of the anterior compartment of the forearm. Now recall that there are three layers of muscles in this anterior compartment, and these muscles are located more medially, so we're looking mainly in this region right here. Because the brachioradialis, which you can see right here, is taking up the majority of the lateral space in this anterior compartment. The brachioradialis is the odd one when discussing the forearm. It's located a bit more anteriorly, and it also flexes the elbow joint, but it's discussed with the posterior compartment because it is innervated by the radial nerve. But enough about the brachioradialis. We will come back to that one when we talk about the posterior compartment. We're gonna focus on this superficial layer and there are actually four muscles, but we're only going to identify these three today. The most medial and more proximally oriented is the pronator teres, which is identified right around here. And you lose some of that, some of the muscle, because it is deep. So you can only see a small portion of the pronator teres right here. When I'm trying to get my bearings in this area, I always try to locate the pronator teres first, as it forms part of this inferior medial border of the cubital fossa. So it's easy to locate this one because it seems like it's almost the start, basically, of this superficial layer. Then we get to muscles that have longer tendons, at least reaching the wrist region or further. And when we're talking about the superficial compartment, the superficial layer, it's really only reaching around the wrist. And so the first one that we see is going to be the flexor carpi radialis. So right here, and you can see its tendon right here, it's going to be the flexor carpi radialis. So radialis is more on the radial or lateral side. And we know this is lateral because this is the first digit. So this is going to be the medial side. So again, flexor carpi radialis is going to be more laterally located. It is going to start with this muscle belly here, and then you see a fairly prominent tendon right there. This skinny neighboring tendon is going to be the tendon of the palmaris longus. This is the muscle of the superficial layer that you're not responsible for identifying. The reason for that, it's not very robust or a very strong muscle, and in fact, some individuals don't have a palmaris longus at all, but if you do see a very skinny long tendon, that's what that is. The last muscle of this superficial portion of this compartment is the flexor carpi ulnaris. It is so medially placed that seeing that its muscle belly is actually quite difficult. We often will see it better in a posterior view. So when we talk about those muscles, we'll talk about or identify the belly there. But one thing that you can see quite well is the tendon of the flexor carpi ulnaris. And as you might imagine, it's on the more medial side. And so you can see the tendon heading towards right around this region here. If you look up in this region, you can see the muscle bellies basically they look like one big muscle. And that's because these muscles share a proximal tendon right around here, which is the common flexor tendon that attaches to the medial epicondyle. So we're on the medial side, that medial epicondyle will be just deep to that, and that's where that common flexor tendon is. Moving to the intermediate layer, and this is considerably less complex as there's only one muscle here, but this muscle does have four long tendons that will traverse the carpal tunnel, and you can see that right around this region here. So here's the carpal tunnel. You can see some of the tendons. Some of them are going to be a little bit deeper, but you can see some of the tendons that will traverse this region. And they will distally attach, so the tendons of the flexor digitorum superficialis will distally attach to the middle phalanges. When you're looking at that superficial anterior view, so this image here is the same image as the one we just talked about, you can see a bit of the muscle belly kind of peeking out between the tendons, those tendons in that superficial layer. Sometimes you actually hear, you have this layer kind of bulked in with the superficial layer, but really it is located deeper. You can see here with the superficial layer removed how wide this muscle is. And again, those four tendons will traverse the carpal tunnel. The flexor digitorum superficialis also has one of its proximal attachments on that medial epicondyle with the muscles of the superficial layer as well. But it also has different proximal attachments as it's such a large muscle. In a deeper dissection, you can see two more muscles, the flexor digitorum profundus and the flexor pollicis longus. The flexor digitorum profundus is similar to the flexor digitorum superficialis in that it also has four long tendons that will traverse the carpal tunnel. So you can see right here the cut tendons of the flexor digitorum superficialis, and then you see all over the place here these four tendons of the flexor digitorum profundus. So these will be located deep to the flexor digitorum superficialis. The FDP, so this is often abbreviated FDP, is going to distally attach on the distal phalanges of 2 through 5, making it the only muscle that can flex the distal interphalangeal or DIP joints. Laterally and neighboring the flexor digitorum profundus muscle is the flexor pollicis longus muscle. And if you see pollicis or pollicis longus or any pollicis, you know that we're talking about a muscle that will affect the first digit or the thumb. And so you can see here that it's going to have this lateral most tendon here. I'm outlining the tendon. And that tendon will actually also traverse the carpal tunnel. So traversing the carpal tunnel, you'll have the long tendons of flexor digitorum superficialis, flexor digitorum profundus, and the flexor pollicis longus. Now, in order to see this last muscle of the deep layer, you have to do an even deeper dissection. So you could almost really split this anterior compartment into four layers, but usually this pronator quadratus is lumped in with the deep layer. And it looks to me, I think this is a very distinctive muscle. It almost looks like a bandage that is covering the distal portions of the radius and the ulna. So this is the pronator quadratus. If you can get to the correct depth, there's little chance of misidentifying this muscle. It's quite distinctive in terms of its shape. And it is this muscle that is typically the prime mover in pronation of the radio-ulnar joints. Excellent. Those are the muscles in the anterior compartment of the forearm. My best advice is that when you are getting confused with muscle bellies, as it is not uncommon, sometimes the muscle bellies are hard to differentiate, look at the tendons and where they are going. These are typically more illustrative than the muscle bellies, particularly the long tendons. Please take time to review and always feel free to reach out to me or any of my anatomy colleagues with any questions. Thank you for your time and attention.